Okay, so today we are making chicken on a chalana. So, we have the chicken that I cooked. I didn't put no spices. So I cooked it up, shred it, and cut it. And I got onion ready and garlic. Where's my garlic thingy? Okay. So, onion, garlic. So, we're going to make the enchilada sauce. And, okay. So, in a pan, and I'm going to do Spanish rice. So, in a pan. Oh, yeah. Put the oven on 350. Okay. In a pan, I got tomato juice in a pan. This is the chicken broth. Don't ask me how much. Okay, and I'm gonna use tomato paste. Gotta thicken it, right? Gotta put some flour and tomato sauce. I put tomato paste. So you can get tomato sauce, but I get enough liquid in here. Tomato juice, tomato paste, and chicken broth. Now they say to use beef broth, but maybe if we were making the beef ones, maybe. I don't know why. I use chicken broth. I boiled up the chicken anyway in the oven. I cooked it in the oven for an hour, 350. So while that is cooking up a little bit, now this is a taco sauce, sorta. I just seen it and I said it'd be good to put in it, right? We'll see. I'm gonna taste it. Stirring it. We want it warm. And I'm going to use, now you could put garlic, cumin, and oregano, and you can make your own, right? But I'm just using the truffle spice seasoning. And I'll probably use about that much, and the other I'll use for the rice. I'll keep this one. That's going to be for the rice. So, I'll keep that one for another day. Okay. So, we're going to blend it all together. We're going to blend that all together. And, yeah, I'm going to do the chicken because I want to... Okay. Well, that's cooking a little bit in the back. Move this in the back. Move it and put this on high. Okay. So, that's simmering back there for that thing. Okay, I need one of these. So, I'm going to take my frying pan. Take the frying pan. And I'm going to put some olive oil. dessert. Okay, so the first thing you put in is your onion. Let it wilt a little bit. Burn them. Then, yeah, so the pandanum's coming. And then we'll probably, I'll film it. See if she likes it. Now, I took this salsa, I did half, and I got cream cheese for, to put on the table. Right? Salsa and cream cheese. I don't have guacamole, but if I had a blender, I put it down, got the avocados, I got the lime, the oil and the garlic to make a guacamole, but I didn't even buy one, I forgot all about it. But anyway, okay, so we're gonna do the onions up here until they're welted, I call welted, I don't know what to call it. Sauce simmering in the back, sort of thing. I want it to thicken up a little bit, but anyway. So, got the onions cooking. And I'm going to put the garlic in. Put the garlic in. That's about good. Oh, come on. I don't want to lose my garlic. My hands. Garlic. So the onion was half of a big one, quite large. So half small one, it would be perfect. Now I did three chicken breasts. That's three. Get the garlic in there. I'm using a knife, but I washed my hands, so, and I didn't lift my fingers. Okay, sorry. Now the three garlic. Some people put four. Totally up to you. How many you want to put? Let me get a spoon or something to get that out. Okay, make sure I get all around it. That's garlic. There we go. So, got that. And I want to rinse it right away. I'm going to rinse it right away. Onion and garlic. Now what we do, onion's not cooked, but not yet. I mean, a little bit more. So get all the garlic. Onions almost cooked. Almost, almost. Let us stir this back here. That tomato paste. Some people put flour. Some people put flour. Okay, so the onions are ready. Starting to brown? That means they're ready. Okay. Now, take your chicken. Shred it and then I cut it, like slice it, like. Okay, so we got the chicken. I'm gonna put it in the oven for about 24 o'clock. They're coming at 5. Oh, I'll probably cook it at 300, cook it low. Okay, get that here. Turn it on. 300. I got lots of time there. 300. Okay, put that chicken in there. Stop talking. No playing around. Okay. That's a lot of chicken. A lot of chicken. And I got the real corn. The real corn, tortilla, so I'm going to probably try to fry it in grease, because that's what they say to do. Then I'll do the rice after. It only takes 15 minutes to do the rice. Okay. So, cook this up a little bit. Okay. Onion and garlic. But I got this to put on top, just in case. And I got the green onion for garlic. I don't want to use all of this in it because I want to put some on top of it, right? So cut that off. You don't need that anymore. And you want to turn that down to 4. And really, it's about, I need more than half. So I want to pour on top. Spicy enough. If not, I'll put in. Got a little kick with this one here because it's hot. Ooh, got a little kick to it. Got a little kick. Just I don't want it too. I need it thick because I got to roll. Roll the turkey is, but I'm going to set that off. I'm going to transfer it in there because I got to fry them up. That is really good. Oh my. Oh my. Could be a little bit sweeter. Could put some people said brown sugar. Wondering if I should put a little bit of sugar, but to sweeten it up a little bit. Okay, did I set the right one off? Yeah, it's working up. I'm gonna put this over here. I'm not gonna make it sweeter. I'll just leave it alone. I'll let it simmer just a little bit. Pour it in there. Then I gotta get the, I guess I'm supposed to cook. I'll need another spoon on for sure. How am I gonna turn them over? But that's cheese. I'll try these to turn them over. If I can't, I'll use them. Yeah, that's what I'll have to do. I'll try it with them. With steel ones. I got plastic ones in here, but they're so bad. I don't want to tear them apart, you know? Now. I should try one. I'm gonna try to do one without crying. I can do it at all the time. That's what I'm gonna do before I cry. I'll still take this out though. Try rolling it, it's too complicated. And I'm not doing it. I'll try it out. This is real corn. Real corn. I've seen people rolling it. I've seen people actually dip in the enchilada sauce and roll it. I've seen some people just roll it dry like this. And I've seen some people fry it in a frying pan. I never ever made these, so this is just an experiment. I don't know what I'm doing, but I got the basics. What I'm doing. I'm thinking take that and take that part. Yeah. Anyway, we'll see. We'll see. If I don't have enough. Okay. So this is all done. I'm gonna pour it in there. But keep. Clean out the frying pan, and the stove doing no work all day, all night. They're getting good pay today, I tell ya. Okay. So, I need a spoon for that. Rinse this out because I might be frying. That off. I might be frying them. I'll keep that oven. That oven is, or that is on. So I'll put that back there. Okay, so I take some of this sauce and put, what did I do with that spoon? Yeah. Put some of this sauce at the bottom. So, I don't know, some people put oil and some people, it's depending on what. Okay, and that's going to be covering it. Okay, let's try it. Okay, let's see if you can see me. Make a mess. If it don't work, then I'll fry it. Okay. Some chicken mixture. Take some chicken. And take some Tex-Mex cheese. Mix it. Let's see. How did the person do it? They put it not really on the hat. I don't want, there we go, over, not breaking yet, so, check it, and do it like that, there's one, now, they're quite big, I do have in case my brown one, right? Chicken and onion. some cheese. Roll it over like that. Y'all get better, right? And I'm not crying. There's two. I got that big long one too. Okay, so let's just shut off that out. That. I don't need these. Because I'm just going to pour it over anyway, right? So. Yeah, too bad I didn't have guacamole. Oh well, that's salsa. I got salsa and sour cream. That's soft, but I'm going to keep the sauce on it and then warm up. There. And I want another one here. Chicken. And cheese. Just don't look like a lot of cheese, but there's a lot of cheese there. Might not have to use the other one. Well, I think I have to bend it first. Have to bend it first and go over. Came apart. I don't think it made a difference. Okay. Now, more of this. See how many I can make. So, if this one breaks a little, then I know not to get the mat. But the other one broke a little bit. Not to get too much. So there's four. I'll do six. Yeah, six and six is 12. And that's how many tortillas I got is 12. Too wet or it'll break. The oil will put a, if I were to fry it, put a coating on it. Yeah. Okay. We'll do it this way. Okay. There's that. Cheese. And put the sides in. I don't know if you guys can see me, I'll have to check. Put that one up. Put that one over. No. The hold side up, right? Hold side up. Put it down a little. Like that. You guys can see me? Let's try. Okay. So. It's six and six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 worked out good. Too bad I didn't have two square pans, but I should be able to fit six in that pan. So, I'm not the excellent roller, that's for sure, but I think this is going to taste good. I think it's going to taste good. Okay. Some people don't like corn flour, so. Corn tortillas. I think I'll ponder with. Okay, so gotta fit this in here like that and squeeze it in and make it fit. Okay, so that one's done. And then I'll pour the sink over it after. Good job, I got a lot of sauce. Let's see if I can fit this in for everything. That's the only square one I have. Yeah. Oh well. We'll see how many. We'll see how many I can do. So, put the chicken in. Put the chicken in. And the cheese. And that. keeps going there, so I'll get another one in there. The squeeze them together.
Okay.
I don't know why I'm doing it like that. Okay. Chicken.
We're still filming?
Yep. So I'll do what it did before. So we taking it out of the oven, and then I'll do a thumbnail, and then that time the phone number will be here. And then we will eat. See if he likes it. I think he will. And then I'm gonna make the rice. So see. Sucker. Another one in there too. They're all gonna open. I gotta squeeze it in. Man. There, good. I'll try to fix it. They're opening. Opening on me. Just have, oh yeah, it's right. Okay. Yeah. Look at it over there. Opening up like a flower. Look. The round one's not very good to use. Anyhow, I'll fix it up. I'm going to do another one. I can put it in the middle and then try to tighten it a little bit. We'll figure out something. What a mess that round was. I could have used the long one, but I think 12 would be too little. You would have to do more, and then they'd open up the floor if they're not tightly in there, right? So, oh yeah, look at this piece back here. Tons of cheese. Yeah. See if I can squeeze it in, close up the other ones. Oh yeah, but keep going. Yeah. I'm gonna figure this out. Close it up as I'm squeezing them in.
Okay.
Because I still have one, two. Okay, we can do that. We can do that. Square one. And this one, not as good, but I did my best. Oh, I didn't put any of the stuff on the bottom. Oh, I didn't put any of that. Okay, so we'll put this in the beer next one. Good. Any of the stuff on the bottom. down further. And it's such a light, it's way down here somewhere. Right? I've got my green on here. I'm only gonna use that much. Okay. So now I take the sauce. More in this one because I didn't put any on the bottom. And this one, I don't need that much. So I put some on the bottom. Just make sure it's all covered in sauce. And these ones too, in sauce. Oh God, it smells good. Okay, so now. So there's no peppers. There's no green peppers in it, so. Now, put this on. And I could put the salsa, see, but we're having salsa on the side. I'm not going to need that, so I'll put it in the fridge. And I'm going to put the rest of the tea. I'm using all of it. I'm using it all. Spices is at the bottom of it. Okay, and I got salsa and sour cream, guacamole we're gonna do it. So get the cheese. I'm going to take some green onions. I'll just do it here. Just chop it up with the scissors, right? The green onions. That's apparently. Just chopping it like this. Almost 4:30, so that's good. By the time they come, this will be cooked and put it strong. Or is it almost? Yeah, it's almost 4:30. Perfect. Perfect. Get this in the oven. Cook it for a little bit. Do the rice. I'm not going to videotape doing the rice. Put that away. The rice, I'm just. Gonna put a little of that, little of this, and water. I'm not gonna put no onion, put that in the fridge. So I'm gonna put this in the oven. And next time you see me, I'll be taking it out of the oven. And so see you in a bit. And I'll put the two together and do a thumbnail, and I'll be here by that time. Okay, so see you in a bit. So part two. They're gonna be here soon, and I'll take them out of the oven. I got my Spanish rice. I got my Spanish rice cooking. It's already cooked. It's just popping out, right? It's just sitting there. So they're mostly the same ingredients that I used in the enchilada sauce. I used in the Spanish rice. So let me get these out. I have to pull you guys back there. Open the oven. So the square one, bacon bits. Bacon bits would have been good too on top. And the round one. So we're going to videotape. I'm going to use a plate for a thumbnail. And then we're gonna tape, so you won't have to. You'll see us eating it as soon as they come. I'll make a plate up and do a thumbnail. anyway. We'll probably have to dish them out with that. So they should be here soon. So see you in a bit, because we're going to talk. And then I'll put these two together. So.